Bad feminism is the lost island for misbehaving women. And it's wonderful there. Bad feminism is a couple different things. It started tongue-in-cheek because I found that as a woman, I really do claim feminism, but I'm imperfect at it. And so I wanted to claim the label while also acknowledging that I'm human and imperfect, and that sometimes I hold contradictory ideas. And at the same time, it was also a correction for mainstream feminism that has historically only focused on white upper middle class women, to the detriment of queer women, women of color, transgender women, working class women. And so, yes, bad feminism is about more inclusion and also accepting that you can be a feminist and you can, as the previous question asker wanted, have it all. Or you can't really have it all, but you can want to have it all. And so, you know,
it's kind of a greedy concept, isn't it? Having
it
all.
So
it's always applied to women, and it sounds unreasonable inherently, right? That's what I dislike about that term.
Absolutely. Well, you know, bad feminism has also moved through the world like a man. Do what you want. Whenever.
Okay, so that would be the moment where we say, Julie, is that your thing?
Well, I don't want to be bad at anything I do. And I don't want to be stereotyped, and I don't want to be pigeonholed. And if I want to self-describe in a particular way, I will. And if others want to self-describe, that's great. But instead of focusing so much on analysing the labels, let's look at what people do. And I'm very proud of what I've been able to achieve as Foreign Minister in focusing on gender inequality in our region and across the world. And I've refocused our aid budget so that our aid budget now focuses on gender inequality. I've ensured that at least $2 billion of our aid budget goes specifically to programs to promote gender equality across the Pacific, across Southeast Asia. Yesterday, for International Women's Day, I announced a partnership with the World Bank whereby we will be working to promote economic empowerment for women in Southeast Asia. Whenever I go overseas, I meet with women, whether they be politicians or journalists or activists, so that I can hear from the women in a particular country what's going on, as opposed to the briefings that foreign ministers usually receive. Personally, I'm a champion of William Hague's initiative about preventing sexual violence in conflict against women and girls. So it's what you do that counts, not what you call yourself. And I think in answer to Kelly's point when she was describing herself and what she wants to achieve, that's fantastic. But of course, there are compromises. Whenever you make choices, there are compromises. But I think it's what we do, as opposed to standing up and declaring, I am a feminist or I'm a bad feminist. It's being judged on what you actually seek to achieve rather than how you label yourself.